So Rena, today we're filming the tag video top 11 of 2011, and I'm sorry I sound so nasally and sick. It's because I am sick. I woke up yesterday with a sore throat, fever, and runny nose, and major migraine. So I am kind of recovering. I'm still not my best, but I am doing better. So I thought I'd sit down and film a video today, and I guess I'll go ahead and get started. But again, excuse my appearance and my voice. The first thing on the list is two face products, so I just picked out two that I used most of 2011. The first one is the Dream Matte Mousse by Maybelline. It just looks like this. You guys know that I have used this. It's my favorite, all-time favorite foundation just because of how nice and creamy and mousse-like it is and how easy it is to apply. So I have used this constantly, and it does have the best, I believe, all-over coverage. So my favorite foundation of 2011. My favorite concealer is the Hard Candy Glamouflage Heavy Duty Concealer. This concealer is by far the best one I have ever used. It does conceal every single one of my imperfections. It has the perfect skin tone color, and this is my top two favorite products of 2011. Next is two eyes. The first one is the MAC Bare Study Paint Pot. You guys know that I like to use this. This is a perfect eyeshadow base. I always like to apply this right before I apply any of my eyeshadows because it just adds the extra glittery appearance to the eyeshadow and kind of brings it out more. So this is kind of what it looks like. You guys saw me use it in a lot of my tutorials. Next is MAC's Naked Lunch. But I quickly fell in love with this one the second I saw it. It's this perfect pinkish kind of beige color, and it's just so pretty, and it kind of just brightens out your eyes, and I always like to use this eyeshadow. So those are the top two eyes products. For lips, Carmex. I love Carmex. So I always use Carmex. I have to use Carmex. It's the perfect chapstick. It's a moisturizing lip balm, and it also has SPF 15 in it, so it's great for protection against the sun. Anytime I have chapped lips or there's something wrong with my lips, Carmex will always fix it. So I have used Carmex for a long, long time, and I will continue to use it. I believe this is the best chapstick there is out there. As well as, you guys know that I really like this MAC lipstick, which is Party Line. I also have used this lipstick constantly. I feel like it's the perfect color against my skin tone, and it really does bring out the rest of the makeup when I apply just this lipstick. So this is again by MAC. Those are the top two lip products. Now for nails, I have the Sally Hansen Extreme Wear color in Red Carpet. You guys know that I don't really like to wear nail polish, but I fell in love with this color, and this color is by China Glaze, and I think it's called Ruby Pumps. It's really pretty, as you guys can see, and my nails are starting to grow out. It's kind of starting to fade out, but I couldn't find it when I went to Ulta, and I know it's online, but I couldn't find it at Ulta to like purchase. So I just searched everywhere, and I went to the CVS pharmacy, and I found this nail polish that looks exactly like my nails. So it like matches it exactly. It's crazy. And this was by Sally Hansen, and it's called Red Carpet, like I stated. And I have been really loving reds, and I have loved reds like all my life, but this is, in my opinion, such a pretty, beautiful color. So I was really excited when I found this color, and it matches the other one perfectly. As for another color that I really like wearing is the NYC Long Wearing Purple Pizzazz Frost in a number 133. This is such a pretty purpley color that has like tints of blue in it and light blue and stuff like that. I love this purple color. And I have this currently on my toenails, so when I do wear nail polish, it's usually just on my toenails. So this is what I've been loving to wear. And those are the top two nail polishes of 2011. As for hair products, I purchased the Remington Anti-Static Straightener. I absolutely love this straightener. It's probably the best purchase I've ever made, and it was very cheap. It was only $15 at Walmart. So this straightener will strain your hair really well. It heats up to like 410 if you want it to, so it'll strain most hair. And it does keep your hair unstaticky, so it does do what it does. So if you have problems with staticky hair, this does work for that too. But I just think it leaves your hair very nice, sleek, shiny, and a really nice feeling to it. So this is the perfect straightener for that. And I love to use this for curling, for crimping, and for straightening. It has been my favorite product, 2011. As for curlers, I absolutely love this curler. I finally purchased a new curler this year. And this was the Remington T-Studio Pearl Curling Wand. I use this all the time to create all types of beautiful curls with it, and it just works great. I've used this in a lot of my tutorials. I still love it, and I will continue to use it for a long time. and then my palette. Since I purchased the Naked palette, I have used this so much in my tutorials. I think you guys got tired of how much I used it, but I absolutely love this product just because it has so many pretty colors you can work with. And I'm a girl who likes to go for a natural color, so all these nice light pinks, browns, dark browns, and colors like these are perfect for me. And the eyeshadow tutorials I was able to create with this palette, and in my opinion, it was a really great purchase. I was really happy to get this in the year 2011. So that is it. That is all the top 11 products of 2011. And I'm sorry about the lighting. I have really bad lighting because it's getting dark outside and the sun's starting to go down. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. And if you have done this video, maybe you can post it down in the down bar as a video response. I'd love to check it out. See you guys soon.